You guys have been asking for this for quite a while.
So we've taken it upon ourselves to make Ben a three-course meal.
In the best way we know how.
Lazily.
Evening, sir. How are we?
Very well, thank you.
Have a good evening.
Dining alone tonight, sir?
Always.
Could I interest you in a bottle of wine, sir?
Please.
Could I recommend you a wine?
A glass of whatever you recommend.
Well, you look like the kind of gentleman that would enjoy a gargantuan Pinot.
Sounds lovely. Is it dry and crisp?
It's fruity. So, at your request, we have a set menu. I shall go and fetch the starter. Take a bread knife and a bloomer loaf, and you want to cut it into lengthwise strips. Once you've cut your vertical strips, now's the time to go horizontally to create cubes. But remember what your grandmother always used to say, don't go near the bottom. Now you've got your lovely little cubes, it's time to cut slices of cheese. I don't like cheese, so I just picked up any old two. One's really strong cheddar, one's red Leicester. Now you want to put your different slices of cheese in between the little crisscrosses of the bread.
There you go.
And I can't stress enough, guys, presentation is everything. Next, stuff your cheesy Czech loaf with parsley, brush it with garlic butter, wrap it in tin foil, and then chuck it in the oven. After 10 minutes, take your bread out of the oven, take the silver foil off, and then put it back in the oven for another 10 minutes.
It's cheesy, heavy on the garlic. What more do you want? I think I'm done.
Can I take this, sir? I shall fill a doggy bag for you immediately, sir.
That's quick.
Yes, sir. One did order a salad, didn't they?
Now listen carefully, because this is the tricky part. You want to take your jar, and then in this very exact order, you want to layer up some salad dressing, some red onions, some red peppers, some cherry tomatoes, some couscous, some chicken, some dried apricots, some pomegranate seeds, some almonds, and the rest of your salad leaves into a jar, and that is your salad sorted.
I have to say, sir, all that work one did, making it look fantastic in that jar, you seem to have ruined in one foul swoop of your scrawny little arms.
It smells incredible, though.
Of course it does, it's from Morocco.
I'm liking the fruit and chicken combo.
I'd call that a success.
Good brunch.
And here you go, sir, your dessert. Oh. There we have it, it's a threesome of your favourite sweet and fruity puffs.
I'm still just dining for one, but I like you. Nice. I don't really know what to say.
Well, this is how I made them. Number one, buy some ready-made puff pastry and cut out some squares. Step two, now this is the bit I'm probably going to muck up, so I'm not going to tell you how to do it. I'm going to let the visuals do the talking. Step three, fold over the left edge over the top, then take the right edge, lift that, and lift that over the top again. Pull a little bit, again, just look at the visuals. Step four, stick it on a tray, slap on some egg wash, and bung it in the oven. For James!
10 minutes.
10 minutes at
200 degrees Celsius.
200 degrees Celsius. I forgot what step we're on, so I'm gonna go with 6. All you have to do is, once it's out of the oven, let them cool down, and stick a blob of ice sugar in the middle of each of them, then put a bit of fruit on top of them all, and it's as simple as that. So it looks like you're enjoying that.
Looks well, it's quite dry.
My, sir, that last Pinot barely touched the sides. Let me top you up.
Barry, looking gorgeous, lacking substance. Jamie, slightly fruity, but a huge portion.
Well.
Mike, incredibly cheesy, a little dense. But all in all, thank you very much. I look forward to 4 years time
and
when you can do it again.
And your favourite is...
Decision.
No, I'm not picking a favourite.
You have to pick a favourite.
That's like a parent picking a favourite child.
Yes, people do it all the time.
No, I just like the wine.
Always goes back to the Pinot.
Brilliant. Yeah,
loves the Pinot.
Maybe as a three-course meal, that didn't work very well, but individual ideas...
I think it worked perfectly. Actually, I think he was just being overly critical for the sheer hell of it.
Now, before we get started, I want to ask you, how was your week? Did you enjoy your week? What did you get up to?
What a nice question.
Because I'm so sick in Fridge Cam of us talking about us all the time.
Yeah.
What have you been up to?
But back to us.
Yeah, what have we been doing?
We've been doing lots of stuff. We've been doing loads of
new stuff
this week.
Yeah,
we started with a brand new series of eye candy. And can I tell you, I think this is probably one of my favourite eye candy videos of all time.
It blows your mind.
My favourite shot is the bottle that's shaking.
It's pretty sweet.
Now, it does remind me.
What?
Eye candy.
Yeah.
Is only half about the recipe.
Yeah.
The other half is about incredible looking food that is uploaded to Instagram or Twitter or even Sorted Food by people like you.
Now, there are two ways you can get involved. Number one, if you have an amazing recipe you want to show us that you think looks beautiful, upload it to Sorted Food. Or if you just see amazing food from around the world, amazing.
That's amazing. The word, amazing.
The word, out, and hashtag it, iCandySorted. We'll find it and stick it in the video if it's amazing. Amazing.
Do you remember that time that you made lamb samosas with Ben?
I do.
And do you remember that about 500 people saw it on the website?
Not enough people saw that recipe.
So do you remember that we put it live on Thursday on YouTube?
We
so that...
did.
Ah.
Go watch it.
Yeah. And then on Friday, we thought we would try something brand new that is based around specific things. So we started off with superfoods. It's something that everybody wants to learn about. And we invited our mate Layla down.
Because she is the expert. It's time for comment of the week.
Yes, it is. Now this one is from somebody called Sydney CA.
Sydney Cat.
They say, true story. I just woke up, head sideways on my laptop, drooling. So I went to the bathroom to clean my face when I noticed a tooth missing. As would be expected, I flipped
out. This is a real story.
Yeah, this is a real story.
Carry on.
After calming down enough to come back into my room to get on the phone and call my dentist, I found my tooth sticking out of the top left corner of my screen. I must have been shocked or something and passed out when trying to eat my computer. Now that I think about it, my tongue was really dry and dusty.
Well, that fridge can, it...
Oh, it pretty much had everything.
It really did.
It had lamb samosas.
It had our gargantuan Pinot.
I just got that. Mm. It had a salad in a jar.
And it had an awkwardly positioned fridge. Good night.
Good night.
Good morning.
Take care.
Good day.
Goodbye.
Oh, so awkward.
Can you move out the bloody way?
What? There's so much pink. It's all clashing.
If you're an American, you're struggling to find red Leicester cheese, simply ask your helpful store clerk for... If you're an American, you're struggling to find red Leicester... If you're an American, you're struggling to find red Leicester cheese, then simply look for... Ah! If you're struggling to... If you're in the US and you're struggling to find red Leicester, then you could just use red Leicester as an alternative.
You missed a bit there. Look at that, that's dry. Look at my... It's dry.
I'd punch him, but he would kill me.
Leicester Square. Mega lols.